that's the actual laptop itself. Zooming in on it, we see it's got a i5 processor, and it has a fingerprint reader, which I've already used to open it up. It's got some nice side front facing speakers, Bang and Olufsen. The sound actually is decent for the system. And yeah, there you go. It has this unique, I wouldn't say unique, but different sort of opening system. So to prop it up a bit, it actually has sort of the actual monitor or screen itself pushes up the bottom, which creates a little bit of a problem with it wearing, and I might show you that later. But yeah, that's the one thing I'd say is a weakness. So let's do as is tradition. Let's look at the I/O. Swinging over to this side, we have plenty of I/O. We have the old HDMI port, ubiquitous and very useful. Couple of USB, full size, nice. Headphone jack and card reader. Swinging around this way, nothing. Swinging over this way, we got some indicator lights. Excuse me. I think I need another shot of that wine. A USB and a networking interface there. So we got an Ethernet plug. So, you know, you can see easily that with those indicator lights that you have connection with a network if you plug it in. You've got power easily seen by that indicator, and you've got your hard drive and your power lights. Nothing on the back, because as we pointed out, the sort of lid of the laptop props it up a bit and it would cover anything that was in the back. This laptop, one of my few laptops, because I don't really like laptops you can't replace batteries easily, does not have a replaceable battery. It's inside the system. So that's the one weakness. The one weakness it has. Looking at the keyboard itself, we see, yes, it suffers from French keyboard syndrome. French Canadian keyboard syndrome. Remap that. Why do you want that sitting on your keyboard? I remapped it to a control key. So we got Alt and now Control. So I always tend to have to do that to these keyboards. But one thing I like is they didn't decide to split this in half, which would have been irritating as hell. I do like the indicator light for the cap locks. Cap lock key. We got kind of a unique cluster of nav key and page up, page down. Very non-standard, but it works. I can get used to this. They're big keys. They're easy to see. You got a delete key. You know, you get your kind of like your standard keys up here. You got a row of your function keys, but they're also, of course, activation keys for special functions like, you know, you're increasing your, you know, your brightness, right? That's actually really useful. Use that a lot. Good to have. So that's good. And then you got, you know, you've got your external monitor for when you have to hook up to a external monitor, or if you want a double monitor. You got a backlight key. Let's see how that works here. Oops, oops. Oh, no, no, no. That's not what we're trying to do. There we go. Let's see. Oh, my God. It has backlight. I've never used that. There you go. It's funny when you use something in an office, you never use it. There you go. So we have backlight. We have a mute. We got, you know, multimedia. We got a key that will actually put it into airplane mode, which is useful if you don't want, you know, your computer to have access to the internet and all that sort of thing. When maybe, you know, you're on an airplane, or if you simply don't need it. So it kind of disables your Bluetooth and your Wi-Fi. All right, so breaking for a second. Talk
cleaner. Very good. Okay. I had to wet my whistle before I coughed up a lung. Let's start off with the CPU Z. So looking at the CPU Z, we can see that it has an i5 6th gen processor, Skylake. And, you know, it's a 14 millimeter process, so much better than most of my laptops in my collection. To give you a little background on this computer, we had a flood in our house, and one of my computers was kind of destroyed in the process. So I had an insurance claim, and I decided, oh, I'll go to Costco and see what I can find there. And this was what came out of it. So this is actually a Costco purchase, and in retrospect, I wouldn't buy a Costco computer. And I don't want to get into details on that, but I just find Best Buy is a better way to go. Better options, better pricing, and better selection. Getting back to the point, it has 2 cores, 4 threads. Like I said, i5, 14 millimeter nanometer process. All the complement of instruction sets. The motherboard is an HP type motherboard, Skylake. Inside graphics, I've updated all the to the latest up to 2019. Memory is DDR3 12, and it's running in dual channel, of course. And we have one stick that is 8. It's a Hynix. It's running at 800, I believe. Let's take a look back. Yep, 800. So running at 800 megahertz. So we got a Hynix. And we got an unknown. So there you go. But that could mean there's two different things that could mean. The slot 2 could either be soldered on, or it could just not be registering correctly. I'm not sure. I've never taken this computer apart. I wouldn't be surprised if they soldered on, you know, 4 gigabytes of RAM because they're assholes and they don't want to make it easy to upgrade anything, because that is the wave of the Apple future. All right, here we go. So we got a Intel Graphics 520 version 7 with a graphics core running at about 1,000 megahertz or 1 gigahertz. There you go. So that concludes our general survey of the computer. From here, we can see some other information like the operating system. It's Windows 10 Home. And same old, same old. Graphics. It's got a... This is where we get into the actual screen. It's got a 1920 by 1080 screen. Very, very high quality graphics on this system, believe it or not. The screen, unfortunately, is so small because it's like, what is it, a 14, 15 inch monitor. So, or screen. So, not so hot. But... you know, adjusted properly, it's quite functional, and it's super light. This thing's small, thin, so great for, you know, mobile sessions at like a coffee shop or whatever. Storage, of course, is a Hitachi one, like realistically 1 terabyte, although it's showing as a 931 gigabyte, effectively a 1 terabyte drive. Temperatures are good, and no optical drive, of course. Audio, yeah, standard Realtek, everybody runs that. Nothing to write home about. Storage, we can look at that. So, like I said, it is really effectively a 1 terabyte, but usable space is actually a 931. It has a recovery partition, Yeah, the smart stuff is all good. Let's get out of there. Oops. Oh my goodness, I'm dropping my phone. And hey, I've only had a sip of wine. Look out if I actually had more than that. Stopping for a moment. He's having another sip. Okay, so here's where we find out what the heck this thing's called. Now, HP has this penchant for naming things with this a silly name, a weird sort of alphanumeric code. So this is called an HP Envy 14, meaning 14-inch display, J153CA, being Canadian laptop. So that's what the deal is with that. Pretty much telling us the same old thing. It's Windows 10, 22H2, and there you go. I haven't run this thing for a while, so there might be updates. I don't know. I hope it doesn't try and do any of that shit tonight while I'm trying to show it off here. All right, so let's go in here. So this is our crystal disk info, which is something I always like to use to kind of get an idea of the health of the hard drive. Of course, it's using a spinning hard drive. Wow, talk about crazy, eh? And yeah, here we go. Let's take a look at how many hours, how many days, whatever. Whoa. So did I just see that right? Is it 943 days? So yeah, this thing's been running a lot. When you actually look at the restarts or the startups, yeah, about 3,000 startups. So what this means is this thing has been running for probably, realistically, you know, a good, I would say 3,000, yeah, maybe 1,000 days, sure, that makes sense. So, yeah, got like maybe 3-4 years, solid use. This was a office machine, which means it ran 24/7, 7 days a week, basically, never turned off. So why I run computers like that is because it doesn't make sense to turn them off, because at night they'll restart, they will do their updates, they'll defrag the hard drive. It's better to leave them running in with Windows 10. So I leave them running. It doesn't actually put a lot of wear on the hard drive, because the hard drive will spin down. And it actually doesn't put a lot of hard wear on the actual rest of the hardware. So it's actually a really good way to run a computer, is just to run it all the time, restart it every day, make sure that it, if there's any updates, to run them before, like at the end of your shift, so that in the morning everything's good to go. And it's a great way to maintain a working workhorse kind of computer that you're going to use at the office. So that's what I did. This is what this is. It kind of hit the end of its useful life recently, and so it was put into the old hobby computer pile. Well, we're heading up to about 18 minutes. Let me get another sip of my wine and we'll continue on. Oh, and you'll notice it's good. It's running at a reasonable temperature. So those are the things I look for. And of course, when it comes to reviewing a computer, this is my go-to benchmark, because it runs on everything. It runs on XP. It runs all the way up to Windows 10. It probably even runs Windows 11, but most of those kind of computers are a little beyond this kind of a hobby computer video. So let's get into it. Let's run it. It always warns us to try and shut down any kind of, you know, close all programs that might be running, but I think we're good this time. So let's give her. Let's giver. Okay, flowing point. Looks good. Coming along. All right, the old integer. Operations. The old hashing speed, CPU. Good, and RAM transfer. This one should be pretty good. It's DDR3. There are DDR4, but you know, it's pretty solid. And here is the thing that usually sinks most of my old hobby PCs, but we know this is gonna run well. You know why? Because it isn't that ancient. And we get a hard drive. Write test, and we're gonna get a score. Here we go. Okay, so if you've ever watched any of my other videos, this is one of the best scores you're gonna see in a old hobby system, 711. And one of the things you'll find with my experience with PCs from, well, particularly laptops, from say, let's go from 2005, 2007, all the way up to 2015. That's usually my range of hobby laptops that either I found it thrifting or through, you know, just depreciating my computers from the office down to hobby systems. You're not going to find a better score than that. Typically, a really high-scoring laptop will be in the 500 range. This is a 711, so this is really quite good. So one of the things you'll notice right off the bat, the RAM scoring probably double what some of my laptops will score. Of course, the CPU is going to run really well. It's more modern, and it's scoring close to 400. But here's the deal. Most of my laptops, the big weakness is that damn graphics. We're getting like stupid scores. 200 frames per second 3D is very good. Score of 64 is excellent for a laptop. You will have a hard time beating that out. And of course, then the rest of it's just a hard score, hardware score, which is mainly just transfer speed with your drive. So, you know, those are the things that govern how your laptop runs. So as far as this is concerned, this is a rockin' hard, rockin' laptop, doing really well. What can I say? Okay, I gotta turn this, yes, it's like, oh, let's go yes. Good, closed out. What do you think of that, awesome, very cool background, my wallpaper. I call this the broccoli tree. Looks like broccoli. Anyway, there you go. There's the there's my latest and greatest review of one of my computers that I've converted from a work computer to being a